Dear students, today we will discuss topic image formation by lenses. Lenses form images by refraction of light, and type of image formation depends on the position of the object in front of the lens. We can place the object at six different positions: infinity, beyond 2f1, at 2f1, between f1 and 2f1, at focus, yani f1, between f1 and optical center O. Image formation by a convex lens for different positions of the object is shown below in the form of table. First we'll discuss about the tabular form. In table you can see, when position of the object is at infinity, the image will be at focus. Relative size of the image will be highly diminished or point sized. Nature of the image will be real and inverted. Second, when object is beyond 2f1, the image will be between f2 and 2f2. Size will be diminished. Nature of the image will be real and inverted. Third, when object is at 2f1, the position of the image will be at 2f2. Relative size will be same, means the object size and image size will be same. Nature of the image will be real and inverted. Next case is, when object is between f1 and 2f1, the image will be beyond 2f2, enlarged, real and inverted. Next condition is, when object is at focus or f1, the image will be at infinity. The size will be infinitely large or highly enlarged, and nature will be real and inverted. The last condition, when object is between f1 and optical center O, the image will be on the same side of the lens as the object, means towards the left side of the lens. Size will be enlarged, virtual and erect. Now we're going to discuss the nature, position and relative size of the image formed by a concave lens for various positions of the object in the tabular form. There are only two situations in case of concave lens. First, when object is at infinity, the image will be at focus. Relative size of the image will be highly diminished or point sized. Nature of the image will be virtual and erect. And second condition, when object is between infinity and optical center O of the lens, the image will be between f1 and optical center O. Size will be diminished. Nature will be virtual and erect. It means a concave lens will always give a virtual, erect and diminished image irrespective of the position of the object. Every time you will get only virtual, erect and diminished image by a concave lens. Now we'll see the image formation in lenses using ray diagrams. For ray diagram, we'll take the image formation by drawing rays. Ray diagram help us to study the nature, position and relative size of the image formed by lenses. For drawing ray diagram, we first consider how light rays falling on both concave and convex lens in three different ways get refracted. First, consider the case of convex lens. In case of convex lens, you'll take three different conditions of propagation of rays. First, when a ray is parallel to the principal axis. You can see in the diagram that after refraction from a convex lens, it passes through the principal focus on the other side of the lens. Second, passing through a principal focus. If a ray is passing through principal focus, after refraction from a convex lens, it will emerge parallel to the principal axis. Third, when passing through optical center of a lens, after refraction from a convex lens, will emerge out without any deviation. It will go straight. Now consider the case for concave lens. Again, there are three situations. One, when ray is parallel to principal axis. You can see in the diagram, after refraction from a concave lens, the ray appears to diverge from the principal focus located on the same side of the lens. Second condition, when passing through a principal focus, after refraction from a concave lens will emerge parallel to the principal axis. Third, when passing through the optical center of a lens, after refraction from a concave lens will emerge without any deviation. Now the ray diagrams for the image formation in a convex lens for a few positions of the object are summarized below in the table. Now using these rules, you can find the images formed by a convex lens. Like when first case we are taking, when object is at infinity, the image will be at focus because all the rays are parallel to principal axis. After passing through lens, they will converge at one point, that is focus. Second case, when object is beyond 2f, that time we will take two rays, one parallel to principal axis which passes through the principal focus, second one is passing through optical center, it will go straight, they will intersect between f2 and 2f2. Third case we are taking, when object is at 2f1, two rays parallel to principal axis will pass through focus, passing through optical center it will go straight and they will intersect at 2f2 only. Next case we'll take, when object is between f1 and 2f1, in that case also we'll take two rays, one parallel to principal axis will pass through focus, second optical center it will go straight. Now they will intersect beyond c2 or beyond 2f2 and they will form enlarged image. Next case we'll take, when object is at f1 or at focus, two rays, one parallel to principal axis, it will pass through second focus and second one is passing through optical center, it will go straight. These both refracted rays are now parallel to one another, it means they will intersect only at infinity. So image will be at infinity, highly enlarged, real and inverted. The last case, when object is between f1 and optical center, will take two rays, one parallel to principal axis, it will pass through focus, second ray passing through optical center, it will go straight. Right side of the lens, you will see that the rays are diverging, so we'll take them back, means towards the left of the lens, they will intersect behind the object. Now image will be virtual, erect and enlarged. Now see the ray diagrams for the image formation in a concave lens for a few positions of the object and it is summarized below in a table. You can see there are only two situations. One, when object is at infinity, the rays are parallel to principal axis, both will diverge right side of the lens, so we will take them back and they will seem to intersect at focus. And second case, object anywhere between infinity and optical center, as in this case we are taking at AB, will take two rays, one parallel to principal axis, it will diverge, one passing through optical center, it will go straight. You can see in the left side of the lens only, there will be a diminished image which will be virtual and erect. Thank you so much.